ladies and gentlemen, we're absolutely delighted to welcome you to another Blackburn Salvation Army charity concert. It's a particular delight to also welcome the members of Blackpool Citadel Salvation Army Band, who are joining with us this evening, along with their bandmaster, Ken Ward, and their officer, John Clifton. Later on, I'll be delighted to hand the leadership of the concert over to them and have a nice rest. But for now, I'll carry on for a little while, and as we're in the Salvation Army Church, we like to begin every concert with a short word of prayer. Dear Lord, we're grateful for the reminder of our former Queen Elizabeth II and of her inspirational Christian witness and years of service. We ask for your guidance for our soon-to-be-crowned new king and all who are in positions of leadership in this country and throughout the world. There's many serious issues to deal with. We'd also remember this evening that those who are not with us, some perhaps lost to cancer, and we pray that as a result of this evening, more steps will be able to be taken to alleviate that particular disease. We thank you for the great gift of music that is in the world and in all of our lives. We thank you for the joy and happiness that can result from it, as well as the moments of spiritual inspiration, challenge and encouragement. And we pray that will be the situation this evening too. We ask all these things in your name. Amen. Now, the band will continue, or the bands will continue with one or two pieces of music, a sort of overture, having done the march. It's a traditional Salvation Army selection, Army of the Brave, arranged by Bandmaster George Marshall. Some of you will be able to see his photograph there. Worked down the mines in the northeast for many years. Then got injured and devoted the rest of his time to arranging music for the Salvation Army. If you can see the front page of the score there, you'll see that it was published in 1923, July. So this particular piece is coming up for its centenary, so nice to feature it because of that. Now, this stuff of Army of the Brave, we wouldn't do so much of that nowadays, would we, the Salvation Army Church? But they took the military metaphor quite strongly at that time. Also, the four songs featured, hardly anybody will know them or any words in them at the moment. Therefore, with each song, I've put something on the screen that may relate to the meaning of the song. In the early days, people used to attack the Salvation Army when it went out doing its open-air services. In wartime, the Salvation Army often provided refreshments to soldiers in different situations. Nowadays, the Salvation Army still provides a lot of social work in many different situations, and accompanying the fourth song will be the Salvation Army activities, some worship services in India, in South Africa, in Scotland, and in the United States of America. That's just to entertain you while the music is being played. So we will listen to Army of the Brave.
Thank you. Thank you.
Joy. We'll try and match. Is it loud enough? What do you think, Jessica? A bit louder? Or is it? Yeah, I'll don't encourage us too much. We'll be on to our second piece in a moment. We've got the band deserve a breath to be down there, even though I don't know what. So, in between pieces, we'll occasionally give bits of information. We know that we're trying to raise donations to Cancer Research UK. I shall read it out. The world's largest independent cancer research organisation funds the work of 4,000 researchers, doctors and nurses throughout the UK, still supports over 200 clinics. I was impressed to read on Wikipedia, which I think is true. Drugs developed by the organisation include cisplatin and carboplatin, and quite a lot of others as well. I recognise the last one, and a few other people here may do as well. Major prizes, they've got their various Nobel Peace Prizes and so on for the great work they've done. So I hope you will be able to support them during our retiring collection. If you leave early, the books are still there, so you won't miss the opportunity. They were so pleased we were making an effort for them. They sent me, is there a banner over there somewhere? Yes, there is. Now you might be thinking they could have spent that fiver on a bit more research. But I think the idea is they're hoping everybody will put at least £10 more in the collection, having seen that, than they would have originally. So there's your opportunity to balance that up. I do have, at the moment, Blackburn Salvation Army were a cash only call. I do have an online way of donating, which I will share via Blackburn Salvation Army Facebook and one or two other means if anybody decides they want to do that in the next few days, but we'll try and get it all completed by the end of this week so that we know where we stand. On to the next piece by the band before we have a change. A piece called Epic Themes of John Williams, featuring a bit of Star Wars, a bit of a comedy war film called 1941, a bit of Superman, and a bit of his music. It's called The Olympic Spirit. We hope you enjoy this and recognise some of the films and tunes involved.
Thank you.
Esperand zooming along there while we're doing something quite exciting. Although the Queen took a nasty turn that way. Didn't I don't know what happened on that occasion. Anyway, water that meets the eye, it seems. Fans are doing absolutely great, Hammy, working really hard. We've had sometimes two rehearsals a week. We've popped over to Blackpool, they've popped here, it's all been great fun. And lovely to share fellowship with people who are making their commitment to society, some contribution to society, to the Salvation Army, as many of us do, and people doing many other different ways as well. I'd like to draw attention to our percussionists. We've got two trainees who are not yet teenagers, right? And another two who are already under teenagers. So, between them, luckily, not just not. Now, it's time for the choir to sing. As you can see from there, the event has been advertised. In fact, choir members of the band could set up now, if you like, to celebrate while I'm watching on. A lovely medley of Beatles songs. Feel free to join in. I've not put the words up, so you can't join in too loudly and let the choir do its bit. But if you really want to join me, even if I'm lost and down, you can sing enthusiastically if you want to. Two more things about it. Hey Jude, when we get to the end, everyone can join me with that. Just so that you know, I think the words are la 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 la. Hey Jude. Should be okay. I would say that I've put the songs in slightly the wrong order. And when we've finished, I'll be giving you a test to tell me which is the first song on the list that is incorrect. So that'll be a nice challenge in a moment or two. It's been a great pleasure to work with the East Lancashire Hospital Choir. Please greet them as they bring the Beatles in with you.
Thank you.
Traditionally, the hospital choir only formed to go September to December, still lasts for quite a few decades, and sings in the Bridgewater Hall with other hospital choirs in the North West to raise this year £15,000 for Young Lives versus Cancer charity. But especially after COVID, a lot of us thought, we'll carry on for a bit. So we've carried on for a bit, we can't go through from now on. A lot of them seem to have expensive holidays, taking up quite a lot of the year once we've got past December, and even more once we've got past March. There's about another third we're normally with us. So if you're free to sing, the first Wednesday in September, 7:30 p.m. back here. I'm always impressed by the number of people willing to start singing Christmas carols or practicing them at that stage. Are you able to shout to me what was the first song that was in the wrong order? Oh well, I was hoping somebody would notice and everybody would shout to me, "All You Need Is Love," which is true, but it would also be the correct answer. Now, I mentioned the banner earlier on, and that it was kind of Cancer Research UK to send it to us. They also sent a lot of balloons, except I'm not quite sure where they have ended up at the moment. Did the New York staff band have balloons on them? No balloons in the New York staff band on them, you know. I shouldn't think them and the international staff band have gotten with their concert tonight either. Now, I don't mind them being patted around the room, for the next item especially. If you can manage to get them on the stage, that would be a lovely challenge for you. You're not allowed to leave your seat though, Jessica, and come running up there. You'll see now that we're going to play a medley of big band swing hits, In the Moon, Stopping at the Savoy, and so on. Quite a jolly piece, that lots of balloons going down would be suitable to be included. Oh, Drash, I've put one of them in the wrong order again. I wonder if anyone's going to notice this time. Could recognise the tune we're playing and tell us which one. Big band swing hits, here we go.
Thank you.
stuff going on there, exciting stuff. You like bike swing stuff? I do, nice rhythm. Should try from looking at it. Quite a lot of fun, you could do a chance to go for a dance. Any idea which one was in the wrong order? No, I was hoping you would shout Opus One, but it was the one called Opus One. But not everybody knows the tunes, even Elizabeth, as well as a lot of people. Now, to give the band a slight rest before our final item of the first half, I'll take the chance, like every year, to advertise. If you're doing nothing tomorrow morning, 10:30, please come along to the Salvation Army morning service. We've got Michael Bublé singing. Oh, sorry, I just read that wrong. We've got Michael Bublé sound-alike, Ben Middleton, singing the song They Could Not. Now, some people will have heard Ben Middleton sing like Michael Bublé at our carol concert just before Christmas. Absolutely brilliant, worth coming to hear him as well as everything else tomorrow. Last time, when he came then, he parked in the car park near the bus station. When he got back to York University in January, he found two £35 fines for driving down the bus lane to get there. So we'll give him lots of support tomorrow. So there he is, Mike. They Could Not. It's a great song, that is, as well. 10:30, Songs of Praise. It's a Songs of Praise meeting, I just remembered. If you can turn up and you'd like to request a song, a hymn, that there's your chance. There's some pieces of paper like this in the foyer to write on tonight, saying what you'd like, what hymn you might like to have sung tomorrow morning. The band's playing an arrangement of Make Your Channel Your Peace. There's lots of people telling me, I like Strange the Shine, because I sing it at school. But whether that will get them out of bed sufficiently early, especially with the extra hour of less sleep tonight, and it's been on holiday too, who knows. I'm told that refreshments will start precisely at 11:30, it's only running for 5 minutes. If you can't make tomorrow, I guess all churches, Christian faith is coming into an exciting time. A week on Sunday, Palm Sunday. So the only time of the year when you can sing Ride On, Ride On in Majesty if you're a bit high church. Children of Jerusalem if you're middle church. Or Graham Kendricks, if you're lowest church. We're all those things at the Salvation Army. I'll be on holiday that week, so it's a good job the choir stopped. Maybe we'll do one of those tomorrow instead. I don't know, it's not my choice. Good Friday, back here at 10:30 a.m. and Easter Sunday, just the same. Now, on to the band's last piece, a suite called Ability, which uses three songs that I knew, choruses really, back in Sunday school. He's able, well, you'll see them as they come up. You may well know that maybe the middle ones are better known than the others. I've put the music for each song on the screen, and hopefully they'll come up at the right time. Now, we've had our tests already. Here's another test. After the band's played this arrangement, which does go on a bit long and jazzes up each of the tunes, then the interval will be all of us singing the same songs. So please pay careful attention to the words and music. Your chance will come for the moment. Let's get the band to play the suite in three movements, Ability.
Thank you. Thank you.
absolutely together at the end, didn't they? One more round of applause for the percussion section, please. I'm looking forward to a rest in a minute while Ken comes over and does all the hard work. Ken had a flat tire on his way here tonight on the M55, so we're doing well, he made it at all, just in time. He hasn't had time to work out how to switch the microphone on. So while we're all singing those three songs, he might come over a little bit. Fingernail on the table. It's your turn in a moment to stand up. And would you mind singing each one twice through? You've heard them a lot. The band version had a few variations on it. We'll try and stick to the normal one. The twice through each song should be good. And then we look forward to Ken taking charge. Please stand up, everybody.
Thank you. That was a march Danforth fitted up by Colonel Bramwell Coles, known as the, if you like, the March King of the Salvation Army. Got written lots of good marches. And if you were to ask some of the bands moving around a little while how many times they've played that over the years, I guess would be well into three figures. Back in the 1990s, the Salvation Army made quite a revolutionary change in that they allowed Salvation Army music to be bought and played by non-Salvation Army bands. Up until that time, the music produced for the Army was exclusive to Salvation Army bands. But it was decided that, you know, it'd be a good thing if bands that aren't Army bands could play our music. And not only that, they said that Salvation Army bandsmen would be allowed to go and play in non-Salvation Army bands. I think they realised that people who were in other bands other than the Army were actually quite nice people, and we wouldn't be contaminated too much by mixing with them. And so that started to happen. Up until then, if you wanted to join, if you were a good player, you wanted to join the top band, you had to leave the Salvation Army to do it. So that was a good thing, because not only do we have a number of our band and some of Blackburn playing with some of the local bands, I think in this case at Eccleston, the Blackpool band, we've got quite a few players who have joined Holton band, one of the local bands. And one of the first to go along was our young lady cornet player, Laura. So she was like one of the first scouts who decided, you know, whether it was worth doing. It proved to be quite a good move for her, because she met Neil, and Laura became Mrs. Jones. And the benefit to us, of course, is that Neil now comes along and plays with our Salvation Army band on a Sunday. And we are very, very glad to have him contributing to us. Neil is now going to bring to us a cornet solo called Don't Doubt Him Now. Are the words for this going to come up on the top?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. So it's a very nice it's a song that's been arranged as a cornet solo. Probably not familiar with the words, so I'm glad that they're going to be up there. And I'm sure you're going to enjoy Neil's rendition of it. Don't doubt him now.
Thank you.
you very much indeed. Back in the 1970s, a couple of Salvation Army captains, John Gowans and John Larson, started writing musicals for the army. And over about 10 or 12 years, they produced about five or six of these pieces. And they were very popular. And a lot of the songs that they wrote for the shows have become standards as far as the army is concerned. And we use a lot of them in our meeting. The next piece is based on one of those songs called Ask. The words associated, if I can remember them, ask and you shall be given, seek and you shall find, knock and the door will open, for God is so good and kind. This has been given a nice upbeat treatment, mambo style. At Blackpool, it's a band piece, but when I came over to rehearse it with the Blackburn band, we all got together, it turned out to be a percussion piece accompanied by the band. So there'll be lots of percussion going on, and things blown, and goodness knows what. It's the dotty, it's going to hit it, but I hope you enjoy this all the same. Thank you.
auction day closes, it's a bit of a sort of funeral plot for people not with us. My last name is Philip Fowler, and the first one is Terry Norton. Good morning.
Thank you. Thank you. evening.
Sorry, it's not that it's heard you before.
It's not a problem. Eric, could you put the word back up here? Amid all the traffic of the ways, turmoils without ruin, make in my heart a quiet place, come and dwell within. We're here this evening to enjoy some good music, but also crucially to raise money for cancer research, aren't we? There's many of us, almost, you know that thing where we put our hands up and say if we know someone or have been ourselves affected by cancer, all of us are going to put our hands up, or the vast majority of us would anyway. Our congregation has been touched and affected by cancer in recent days. We've had people who have passed away. The Salvation Army, we say, promoted to glory because they're with Jesus now. There are people who are ill at the moment. We know the impact of it. For me, in a personal sense, 12 years ago, my mum died. She's with Jesus now. She had cancer. As we were preparing for this evening, as I was thinking about what I was going to say, I thought I'd talk a little bit about my mum and the experience of when she was ill. In the context of this song as well, amid all the traffic of the ways, turmoils without within, make it my heart a quiet place, and come and dwell within. Have you experienced that moment when you're told that someone close to you is very unwell? It's not nice, is it? It's not a nice experience. Turmoils without within. Sometimes, I don't know if you find this, but it's the person who's actually ill who is actually the most calm. You've seen that? You notice that sometimes? It's an amazing thing. And that was certainly the case with my mum. But as we look to that first verse, make in my heart a quiet place and come and dwell within, I know that she could see the turmoil going on around her. She could see that we were all worried. What are we going to do without mum? What are we going to do without her? Life isn't going to be the same. Our family's going to be all messed up, right? And mum's not there. But there was this thing about in the midst of her illness, I very much seen there is the case that Christ indeed come and dwell within. In the midst of that situation, but in her. And I think it's the case, the Bible certainly indicates this, that in the midst of situations like that, that Christ is indeed there. And that when we're with people, when we're meeting people who are in situations like that, who are in these conditions of powerlessness, such as illness, such as sickness, that he indeed is there, that he's really there. Matthew 25, verses 31 to 46 tells us this. It says, whatever you do unto the least of these, may you do it unto me. It says, I was hungry, and you fed me. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was naked, you clothed me. I was sick. I was imprisoned, and you visited me. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. In all of these situations, you see, Christ is there. And Christ, his first name is Jesus. Jesus Christ. Yeah. He was there. He was in the midst of that situation. And we encountered him in my mum in the midst of that. Okay? And I would encourage you now perhaps to bring to mind people that you're aware of who might be ill at the moment, particularly those who are suffering with cancer who are affected by that. I want you to bring them to mind. I want you to be aware that Christ is in the midst of that situation. Jesus Christ is there. And that when you meet those folk, when you meet those people, that actually you're also encountering Jesus Christ as well. And I think the way it works is that when we care for people who are ill, yes, indeed, we do care for Christ himself, but there's perhaps a broader spectrum of what it means to care for those people. And I think what we're doing here this evening, I would encourage you, yeah, as Pam or Sir Eric has said, you know, Cancer Research said £5 poster, so that adds a tenner, I think, was that the... I think that a tenner per person, I understand. I like the maths. But as we give, I encourage you not just to be giving, oh yeah, it's a great evening, thanks, band worked hard, everybody sang wonderfully, the choir sounded fantastic. I encourage you not to be in that sort of spirit. I encourage you to be giving it as an act of worship. As an act of worship, that as you give, that we are hoping that some sort of change might be made in the lives of those who are affected by this illness. Cancer's rubbish, isn't it? Yeah? Don't sound very convinced. Cancer's rubbish. Yes, it is. It's the worst. It steals people that we love from us. But in the midst of those situations, see Christ. Find him there. Encounter him. Be with him. Recognize his presence. And as you give this evening, give in that spirit as an act of worship. Not simply a transaction, not simply money in a collection bucket, but as an act of worship. We'd ask that of you. I'd like to say thank you to you all for coming. I'd like to say thank you to Bandmaster Eric and to Bandmaster Ken for all the work that they've put into this evening. I'd like to thank the band as well, respective bands. And Majors Ashley and Nazarene, thank you for hosting us here. We appreciate you. The last time I got to play, that's Major Ashley over there. Do you know him? Some of you? The last time I got to play in a band with Ashley Dawson was in Lahore, in Pakistan. And we would go through the streets in a van. And we'd go to different places, wouldn't we? And I used to play cornet then. I've graduated to double B-flat bass. But on that note, just taking a little trip down memory lane. Right? Sorry, I saw that there's a limit of 5 minutes on the sermon here. Oh, that's tomorrow. No. 2 minutes tonight. Well, I'll indulge myself. I've got the mic. You shouldn't have given that to me. anyway, as you give, what do you have to do? Give in a spirit of worship. Okay? Because in the midst of that, in the midst of that gift, we encounter Christ. God bless you. And we're going to play something else now. What are we going to play? Pioneers. We're going to play Pioneers. And Van Master is going to share a bit about that. God bless you.
Pioneers. It's one that in days long gone by we would play regularly, perhaps at an open air service on the promenade. The young ladies would have their tambourines and they would accompany the band, or the band would accompany them, and it was always a good crowd puller. You know, people would come along to see what was going on, watch the tambourines, listen to the band. Sadly, those days are gone. These days, if we want to march down the street, we've got about 4 people in flak jackets as well, doing all the policing, making sure we don't get in the way of traffic or they don't run into us. But it's a good march, one of them joy. It was actually, the words associated with part of it were actually a funeral song. And you might have heard it played on the streets of St. Louis, somewhere like that. And the words were in part of the verses I got. I'm a pilgrim and a stranger, wandering through this world of sin, on my way to that fair city, when the saints go marching in. So when we get to the bit, you know, join us. Thank you. Well, we come to our last piece of the evening. The second harm has been quite light, so I thought perhaps we should play something a little bit more serious. So I thought Beethoven's 9th symphony might be a good one. So we'll go at that. For those of you worried about catching the last bus, it's quite on. If you're not going to play it all, we might just stick with the fourth movement, and maybe not even all of that. The melody in it, it's known as the choral symphony, by the way, if you're not familiar with Beethoven, because he has to put words to this bit, which are a bit serious, but it's been adopted, you may know, as sort of the anthem of the European Union. And in our tune book, this tune is called Euro. So this is a more upbeat version. I'm not sure if Beethoven would like it or if he approved or what, but he was quite a revolutionary composer in his own right, so maybe he wouldn't think it's that bad. It's another arrangement by Len Valentine. There are words associated with it, which are going to come up on the screen. There's the first verse. So please join in and sing. All you've got to do is just keep up.